Good morning. Does God intervene in history? We're at Jeremiah 7, verses 32 to 34. Therefore, behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when it will no more be called Tophet, or the valley of the son of Hinnom, but the valley of slaughter. For they will bury in Tophet until there is no room. The corpses of this people will be food for the birds of the heaven and for the beasts of the earth, and no one will frighten them away. Then I will cause to cease from the cities of Judah and from the streets of Jerusalem the voice of mirth and the voice of gladness, the voice of the bridegroom and the voice of the bride, for the land shall be desolate. Here is a picture of total cessation. Everything basically stops. It's a picture of judgment. Life as they know it will end. No mirth, no joy, no marriage, and the dead are going to fill the place up. The wickedness of a people who've gone away from God quite intentionally, it's going to catch up to them. He never abandons his people, but they've been known to abandon him. Now, you and I both know that the biggest argument against Christianity, it's not that there's hypocrites in the church or that the Bible doesn't measure up or any of these kind of things. The biggest argument against Christianity is that people don't want to feel morally accountable. When we read here, we find, oh, we are very morally accountable. Most people think that they'll have the most enjoyment when they're not under the constraints of morality. If they're not kept to account, if they can do whatever they want without limitation, they somehow think that'll make them happy. It's not that the arguments against there being a God are persuasive. It's that they don't want there to be a God. Creatures made by God, given the gift of life by God, offered the gift of eternal life by him, want to live without reference to him, without reference to right or wrong, and they want to forget him. In fact, what they want in their religion is a way of forgetting God while they sort of make believe that they're remembering him. And, you know, mostly they get their wish. Mostly in this life, God withholds his you know, on the large scale, the big interventions. He lets people try their sugar-coated, imagined, happy hour lifestyle. And when that runs its course, a lot of people discover that that's really actually very thin. It's really actually very hollow. And some of them will turn to God. They need to discover their thirst before they become determined to drink. Sometimes corruption becomes so deeply established in a culture, even in a church, that there has to be a massive putting away. A lot of people need to be decommissioned, so to speak, before there comes moral change for the good. And we see that historically. Here's one of those cases. You didn't make it up. I didn't make it up. We just see that God does work this way sometimes. The rod in the kingdom of Judah is very great. And Jeremiah makes the sad prediction that large numbers will not turn to him. He says that the slaughter will be enormous. God is clear. Did you see it in the text? He will cause this situation to come to its culmination. He will cause the situation to come to completion. While mostly we see God not intervening in history, he reserves the right always to decidedly intervene in history. And occasionally he does. He's still on his throne. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, what we see here in this picture, it looks grim to us, but it's actually positive. It is you cleaning house. It's you letting sin run its course, letting the disease go to the destruction so that people can actually see that, you know, A leads to B and that the consequences of sin is death. And so, Lord, we know that this is not something you enjoy, but it's something that from time to time you allow to happen. It's happened in many churches. And Lord, we just want our hearts to be right, and we want so that you won't have to do this yet again. So cleanse our hearts, Lord. Help us to be on your team. Help us to have our eyes open, Lord. When you bring things to the conclusion, please, Lord, help us to be a part of the solution and not a part of the problem. Help us to have the Spirit of Jesus in us, Lord, so that we can lead other hearts to you. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Does God intervene in history? Yes, he does. Let's not forget that God is God, we're not. This is good news because you and I would be very poor gods indeed. God be with you today.